Hello! Today I've got a... What a weird way for that. Hello. Today I've got a new tutorial for you, obviously. And this time it's about a cut crease. And yeah, I've done cut creases on myself in the past. I was never quite happy with it because... I don't know, I just don't think a cut crease, like the official way to do a cut crease with the, you know, the crease a little bit above your actual crease. I don't think it works well with my eye shape. It makes it look almost drag-like and that's really not as usually what I'm going for. So yeah, this doesn't seem to fit my face shape properly. Blah. It's very early in the morning. I can't talk properly. But yeah, so what I did this time is actually put the line in my actual crease and of course do the little wing out, and I finally have a cut crease on my face that I'm happy with. Finally. Actually this tutorial isn't even all that difficult. It mostly just takes a whole lot of time. It does take a lot of time. I think I was at it for like, I have no idea, an hour and a half, maybe two. But either way, it is actually really fun to do, so let's get started. As always, I'm going to start with priming my eyelids, and seeing as I do it the same way every single time, I'm just going to skip ahead to the actual eye look. So this time I decided to go for nude shades, and I dusted off my Naked 3 palette, which I barely ever use, even though it's absolutely gorgeous. I just don't seem to go for nude shades very, very often. So yeah, decided to go outside my comfort zone today and use them. I'm going to start out with the transition shade on a big fluffy blender, and I'm just applying it all over my crease and a little bit in my outer corner. You don't actually need to apply this in your outer corner, I just randomly forgot what I was planning on doing and applied it there anyway. And the other colors I did actually keep in the crease. I just basically went to smaller brushes each time and darker shades of sort of taupe-ish colors. I really wanted to keep the cut crease a matte shade and then the eyelid a shimmery shade. And yeah, as always, I'll just leave everything I've used below in the description box. However, of course, if you don't have the Naked 3 palette, you can just use whatever eyeshadows you have that you prefer. You know, it really doesn't matter as long as you're using stuff that you're comfortable with and that you enjoy using. So yeah, I am, by the way, keeping the darker shade in the crease by blending it with the smallest brush and then just going over everything with a big fluffy blender. To keep it all nice and smooth, and then I actually use the Kiko shades as my darkest shade in the crease. Simply because the black shade in the Naked 3 palette has red glitters in it, and as I said, I really wanted to keep the crease matte. And I'm really, really, really trying to not blend this up too far, because I did want the taupe to stay visible up there. So I'm really only blending this with the tiny brush. Then I decided to give this eyeshadow primer another chance. Yeah, I'm still not sure what I think about it. I applied it with a concealer brush this time, which does go significantly easier than applying it with any form of fluffy brush, but I guess I should have known that because it is a cream product. But it just goes weirdly bumpy, and if you brush over it too often, it actually takes the, the powder and the concealer off the eyelid as well. It's really weird. However, you know, shimmery shades do look absolutely gorgeous over top of it, as you can see. But if anyone knows a good shimmer primer that doesn't go weirdly bumpy, I'd love to hear about it, because, the bumpiness just sort of bothers me. As you can really see it on camera as well. But yeah, I just applied a sort of rose gold shade at the center of the lid, then a slightly paler shade at the cut crease part, or like the edge of it. And then a shimmery, almost glittery shade in the inner corner. I didn't do a full highlight yet, because we still have to apply all the other face makeup, obviously. Then I went back to the cut crease with a very, very tiny brush and the Kiko black eyeshadow, just to define it a little bit more. And then I made an attempt to blend it with this particular brush, which of course doesn't work at all, because it's very, very tiny and very hard, really. Not painful hard, but you know, it's a stiff brush. So yeah, I actually switched to a pencil brush to properly blend it out. And just keep blending and applying until you're happy with it. And then once I finally was happy with it, I moved on to eyeliner. I'm using the Maybelline Line Refine today, which has a very nice thin brush. This is really the sort of brush that I love for liquid liner. And I finally actually managed to do a thin liner on myself, like it's usually when I'm filming. Like, I can do perfect thin liners when I'm not filming, but for some reason when I'm filming I always end up with a massively thick liner for some reason, even though I tried to go for a thin liner most of the time. This time I did actually manage to go for a thin liner, and then I also used a white pencil in my waterline. Like I said at the beginning, at least I think I said it at the beginning, I wanted sort of a wearable cut crease. So I didn't want it to be too dark, I just wanted it to look sort of almost natural-ish, I guess. As natural as I'll go for a, you know, makeup. Then on my lashes I used the Yves Rocher Vertige Mascara. As you can see, it has a really, really tiny wand, so it really gets to the base of the eyelashes. And I want to wear falsies, so I really wanted my lashes to be black from the bottom upwards. And I also love it on my lower lash line, or, you know, lower lashes. Makes them nice and spiky, which for a natural look isn't not as usually what I go for, but for this type of look, I think it looks awesome. And then for lashes, I used eBay lashes and my Peggy Sage eyelash glue. Strangely enough, the color of this eyelash glue is white, even though it dries translucent, which, you know, I think is a lot better than something that actually dries white. But yeah, I'm not quite sure why they didn't just call it translucent. But anyway, I stuffed my fake lashes on there, made sure the inner corner was properly attached, and then just spent a moment admiring the falsies. Then for my skin, I started out with the Maybelline Baby Skin today. Actually, recently rediscovered it by tidying up my makeup drawers, and yeah. I actually forgot how much I like this stuff, like it doesn't seem to do much moisturizing on my face, but it does make it really, really, really smooth and it really does seem to fill up my pores a little, which is nice. So yeah, just dabbed it into my skin, that seems to work better than, you know, brushing it over it. And yeah, just kept patting it in until it was done, and then I actually used a foundation which I've had for months and I really have been wanting to try it on camera and I kept forgetting about it. It's a serum foundation by The Ordinary in almost a pale shade, not quite a pale shade. They really have a very good color range and I just blended it out with my beauty blender. And yeah, they also have a coverage foundation, so, you know, the serum foundation isn't meant to be full coverage. And it isn't, it's, I'd say, light to medium coverage, but it is very nice, it almost gives sort of a Photoshop blur over the face. On me it's not very long wearing, but I have oily skin, I think that it would be actually better for, you know, dry skin, and here I'm just, you know, flirting with my concealer. It's actually my favorite concealer. And yeah, this is actually, and that says a lot, this is the only concealer that I actually have a spare one of. It's the Catrice Liquid Camouflage in the shade Light Natural. Absolutely awesome concealer. It doesn't crease on me. It's just, it has a perfect coverage. Easy to use, easy to spread, it looks lovely on top of any foundation I've ever tried it on top of. It looks lovely without foundation underneath it. I just really, really, really love this concealer and it's also budget friendly, which is always nice. Then I also set it with my Catrice Primer Fine Powder. With a smaller brush underneath my eyes first, just because it's easier to reach the inner corners that way and to not go over my wing as accident. And then for the rest of my face, I just used a big fluffy powder brush. Just because it's obviously a lot quicker than the, you know, tiny brush would be. Then for my lower lash line, I grabbed the pencil brush again and just went for the rose gold shade. Pretty much at the outer half of the lower lid. And then just a shimmery shade in my inner corner again, just to highlight it some more. Then for my brows, I used the L'Oreal Brow Artist Brow Plumper. Plumper? I keep calling it plumber, but it's plumper, yep. But yeah, I'm just using that to set my hairs in place. By the way, I do actually tint my eyelashes, so if they look darker occasionally than they are at other times, every 2 weeks I actually tint them myself. But anyway, to fill them in, I used my Tame & Frame Brow Pomade by NYX and my trusty nail art brush. I really love very thin brushes for my eyebrows, and yeah, I don't have a set eyebrow routine, I just, you know, see whatever fits with the look. This time I decided to do the back end quite harshly and the front end more hair strokey. Yep, more like the natural way. Defined and natural in one, I could call it. Then to highlight it, I used the palest shade from the Naked Tree Palette on a short shader. And then it's time for bronzer. Lately I've really been into actual bronzing rather than, you know, sharply contouring. I'm not sure why, it just differs for me what I prefer. And yeah, for this I actually really, really love this Abilene brush. It's really fluffy and sort of oval almost. The bronzer I'm using is the Big Bold Bronzing Powder by New York Color. You know, the one in a huge pan, and it's absolutely huge. I've had this one for years and I still haven't hit pen on it. Like, it's absolutely ridiculous, really. But yeah, it is a nice bronzer. I'm also bronzing my neck just because I don't know, I just think it looks nicer if that actually plays along with my face. Then for blush, I used a sort of burgundy-ish blush by Yves Rocher in the shade Rose Hortensia with a stippling brush. This really just blends it out very nicely, and I didn't want the blush to look too harsh. Then for highlighter, I also went for quite an almost subtle highlighter. It is a very beautiful highlighter. It's by Kiko. I'll put the number, because I don't remember it, below in the description box along with everything else I've used. But yeah, instead of a really truly glittery one like I usually prefer, this one is more of a shimmery one. But I really wanted to keep the attention on the eyes this time, so that's why I went for this shade. It's a lovely warm white gold-ish shade. It's very hard to describe, but I think it's stunning. Then for my lips, I decided to go for nude this time, and this is actually a very rare nude that looks good on me. I think very pale nudes just don't work right on me. I prefer shades like these. This one is Maroon by Catrice. And what I always like to do is just apply it, you know, normally, and then I actually use my finger to go over it, just to take off any excess product and to make it all go more or less matte. For one, I think it looks nicer, but I also feel as if it makes the product last longer on my lips. And then here is the final result. I really, really like how this turned out, actually. Like, I was seriously surprised about that, because as I said in the beginning, cut creases don't usually look nice on me. But yeah, this way of doing a cut crease actually does work on me, and I really, really love the contrast between the shimmery lid and the matte crease. So, here's my entire tutorial, or at least the end of the tutorial. I really hope you enjoyed watching this. If you did, please click the like button, it would really help me out. And if you want to, you can also subscribe to my channel. For now, as always, thank you very much for watching, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!